Hello, Griff Rees here from Gwen and Griffith, and today's video we're going to be reviewing the Stanley Anti-Vibe Hammer. And on first looks, very good looking hammer. She's got a lot of over-engineering bits here, which looks really cool. I know a lot of trade men, they like those fancy bits. The Anti-Vibe there, sticking out in steel. Very heavy hammer, she's almost 2 pounds in weight, and I think she's an extra length hammer as well. If we just measure that, that's almost 35 centimeters long. But the unique factor about this hammer is this extra wide hitting head. So I'll just measure that for you. So it's almost 4 centimeters wide. I think most hammers are roughly 3 centimeters wide. So you've actually got a full centimeter of coverage here, which is quite handy. If you're pretty bad on a hammer and you keep missing the nails, I think this hammer will help you out fairly with that. Or if you're hitting in big 6-inch nails and you really want to be giving it a clout, this can take the impact and penetrate the nail into the wood for you. But the main factor that I bought this hammer was not because of that. It's because this little feature here, you've got a little slot here, a magnet, and a back plate there. So what that enables you to do, enables you to put, I've just got a 4-inch nail here, it enables you to put a nail in there, the magnet holds it in place so it doesn't fall out. So you can hit the nail in one-handed, and that's not a big deal really, but if you're fencing by yourself, like I do a lot of fencing by myself, a lot of post and rail, etc., this is very handy. So my left hand is holding the rail, obviously my right hand is holding the hammer, so I don't need to be again using a third hand if I had one, or can someone help me to hold the wood for me, to hold the nail to start it off. This enables you to hit the nail in one-handed without using your left hand. So I'll just demonstrate that. Solid piece of oak here, this is much harder material than softwood rails that you use for fencing. So I just demonstrate this. One hit, penetrates the wood quite nice, and then your way to go then to hitting the nail all the way in. And another reason I bought this hammer, every hammer I buy, I always buy it in full steel. I never buy a wooden handle one, or those chrome tube handles one, which is either welded here or pushed in. Those hammers are no good, especially if you're fencing and using six inch nails. Try to pull out a 6-inch nail with those hammer, they will always fail you and break off. So they're just a complete waste of time and money. Always invest a little bit more in buying a quality hammer like this. So overall, really nice hammer. I really like it. And I found out by accident, the steel in here is very, very good, very strong. I was topping the field with a tractor one day, and this was it. I had the back window open, and this fell out the back and went straight into the flail. I heard the bang, knocked the PTO off, went to retrieve the hammer, thinking the hammer was going to be absolutely chills. But the hammer was there, no damage, luckily it didn't hit this side at all. But it did hit the head here, and I thought, oh, here we go, that's going to be some major damage. But actually, when you think of the force of the flail mower on the tractor, that's all it did, was just put a little dent in there. There's no fracture line coming down here at all. So the hammer took the full hit of the flail and didn't crack. She just dented a little bit. So that shows the quality of steel you've got in this hammer. So overall, very pleased with this. She goes fencing with me every time I go fencing. And I would rate this hammer a good 9 out of 10. Very, very good hammer. I think a lot of it. And I would highly recommend you to buy one. Thanks for watching the video. Stay tuned for more. Thank you very much.